Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn the next topic, name is sampling. First of all, we see some basic concept or definitions regarding to the topic of sampling. So the first definition is population. What is the population? Population is nothing but the group of individuals, or the group of observations is nothing but the population, or the aggregate of all individuals under study is nothing but the population. What is mean by individual? Individual is nothing but the person or object which is included in the study. Then the next definition is sample. What is mean by sample? Suppose this is the population. There are group of individuals. So individual is nothing but the person or object which is included in this study. Then what is the sample? Sample is nothing but the finite part of population. Suppose I am selecting some object from the population, then this object is called as the sample. Sample is nothing but the finite part of population. What is mean by sampling? Sampling is the process of selecting these samples from the population is called as the sampling. Sample is nothing but the finite part of population, but the selection, that is the procedure of selecting the sample from that population, is nothing but the sampling. Now the next definition is sampling units. What is mean by sample? Sample is nothing but the finite part of population. Suppose this is the population, finite part of population is nothing but the sample. Then what is mean by sampling unit? An elementary unit or group of elementary unit which are convenient for sampling and on which we make the observations are made are called as the sampling units. This sample we are used for the further study. So an elementary unit, that is single unit, or the group of elementary unit which is convenient for sampling and on which we make the observation, we make the observation on these units. So this is called as the sampling unit. That means unit in the sample is called as the sampling unit. In health survey, patient will be the sampling unit. Also in socioeconomic survey, family is considered as a sampling unit. Now the next definition is variable. What is variable? A characteristic of individual to be measured or observed, called as the variable. There are two types of variable, quantitative variable and qualitative variable. What is mean by quantitative variable? Variable has a value or the numerical measurement. That means the variable which are to be measured called as the quantitative measurement, quantitative variable. And qualitative variable means the attribute. That means the variable places an individual in a category or a group. That means the variable which are not to be measured, called as the qualitative variable. Qualitative variables examples are eye color or beauty, etc. Okay. Now the next is senses. What is mean by senses? The measurements or the observations from the entire population are used for the study. Senses means, in a census, each and every unit in the population are used to study. So census is nothing but the complete enumeration process where the each and every unit from the population is used for the study. Now the next is sample size. What is mean by sample size? The number of sample units in the sample. Suppose this is the population. Population suppose having the 100 units. I am selecting the 10 samples. So what is the size of sample? The sample size is 10. The number of sampling units in the sample is called as the sample size. And sample size is denoted by small n, and the population size is denoted by the capital N always. Now the sampling frame. A complete list of sampling units which are present the population to recover is called as the sampling frame. A complete list of sampling unit is nothing but the sampling frame. For example, list of voters, the name of the voters, in the list of that voters is nothing but the sampling frame. Also, the second example, list of villages in a district. So, this is also a sampling frame. Now, the next is merits and demerits of sampling. Now, the next definition is variable. What is variable? A characteristic of individual to be measured or observed, called as the variable. There are two types of variable, quantitative variable and qualitative variable. What is mean by quantitative variable? Variable has a value or the numerical measurement. That means the variable which are to be measured called as the quantitative measurement, quantitative variable. And qualitative variable means the attribute. That means the variable places an individual in a category or a group. That means the variable which are not to be measured, called as the qualitative variable. Qualitative variables examples are eye color or beauty, etc. Okay. Now the next is senses. What is mean by senses? The measurements or the observations from the entire population are used for the study. Senses means in a census, each and every unit in the population is to be are used to study. So census is nothing but the complete enumeration process where the each and every unit from the population is used for the study. Now the next is sample size. What is mean by sample size? The number of sample units in the sample. Suppose this is the population. Population suppose having the 100 units. I am selecting the 10 samples. So what is the size of sample? The sample size is 10. The number of sampling units in the sample is called as the sample size. And sample size is denoted by small n, and the population size is denoted by the capital N always. Now the sampling frame, a complete list of sampling units which are present the population to recover is called as the sampling frame. A complete list of sampling unit is nothing but the sampling frame. For example, list of voters, the name of the voters. In the list of that voters is nothing but the sampling frame. Also the second example, list of villages in a district. So this is also a sampling frame. Now the next is merits and demerits of sampling. First of all, we see the merits of sampling. So the first merit is it saves the time. Means that the sampling method of data collection saves the times because the fewer items are collected and processed. In a sampling, only the finite part of population is used for the study. So it saves the time. Now the second merit is it reduces the cost. Since only the few and selected items, that is individuals, are studied in a sampling, there is the reduction in the cost of money and the reduction in terms of the manners. Okay, now the third merit is more reliable results can be obtained. That means through the sampling, more reliable results can be obtained because there are fewer chances of sampling statistical errors. If there is the sampling error, it is possible to estimate and control the results. And the second thing is that highly experienced and trained persons can be employed for the scientific processing and analyzing of relatively limited data, and they can use their high technical knowledge and get more accurate and more reliable results. Now the fourth merit is it provides more detailed information. That means as it saves the time, money, labor, more detailed information can be collected in the sample survey. Now the fifth is sometimes only the sampling method is to depends upon. That means sometimes it is so happens that one has to depend upon the sampling method alone, because if the population under study is finite, sampling method is the only method to be used. For example, if someone's blood has to be examined, it will become the fatal to take all the blood out from the body and study depending upon the total enumeration method. In this example, doctor take only the sample from the blood, not entire body blood. Okay. So that time the sampling method is only used. not a census method, that is complete enumeration method. Now the sixth is administrative convenience. The organization and administration of sample survey are easy for the reasons which have been discussed earlier. Okay. Now, the next is more scientific. Since the methods used to collect the data are based on the scientific theory and the results obtained can to be tested, the sampling is a more scientific method of collecting the data. Now, let's see the demerits. The first demerit is illusory conclusion. If the sample inquiry is not carefully planned and executed, the conclusion may be inaccurate and misleading. Now, the second demerit is sample is not a representative. To make the sample representative is a difficult task. If a representative sample is taken from the universe, the result is applicable to the whole population. If the sample is not representative of universe, the result may be false or and misleading. Now, the next third is lack of experts. As there are the lack of experts to plan and conduct a sample survey, its execution and analysis and its result would be the unsatisfactory and not trustworthy. Now, the fourth demerit is sometimes the more difficult than the census method. Sometimes the sampling plan may be the complicated and requires more money, labor and time than the census method. Next demerit is personal bias. There may be a personal biases and the prejudices with regard to the choice of technique and drawing of sampling units. Now, the sixth demerit is choice of sampling size, that is sample size. If the size of sample is not appropriate, then it may lead to untrue characteristics of the population. And the last demerit is conditions of complete coverage. If the information is required for each and every item of the universe, then a complete enumeration survey is better. Now, the next is objectives of sampling. So, the first objective is to get much more information as possible of the whole population by examining a part of it. So, the second objective is sampling aims at gathering the maximum information with minimum efforts, cost and time. Sampling needs the less money, less cost and less manpower. So, we gather the maximum information with minimum efforts by using the sampling. And the third main objective of sampling is to remove the difficulty in census, because in census each and every unit in the population is used for this study. But in sampling, the finite part from the population is selected for the study. Now, the next is types, that is methods of sampling. So, how to collect the sample, the procedure of collecting the samples from the population. So, first method is, that is types of sampling, is random sampling. Second name is probability of sampling. There are the two types of random sampling. First is simple random sampling, that is unrestricted sampling, and second one is restricted sampling. So, the simple random sampling or unrestricted random sampling having two types, simple random sampling with replacement and simple random sampling without replacement. And the restricted random sampling having the three types. First is stratified random sampling, second is systematic sampling, and third is cluster sampling. Let's see one by one. So, first is simple random sampling. So, simple random sampling or unrestricted sampling is the technique in which each and every unit of the population has the equal and independent chance of being included in the sample. That means that in the simple random sampling, each and every unit in the population has the equal chance of selection. In this method, thus the selection is free from the personal bias of investigator. Because each and every unit has the equal chance of selection, so the selection is free from the personal bias. There are the two types of simple random sampling. One is simple random sampling with replacement and second is simple random sampling. Now the first is simple random sampling with replacement. In this type of sampling, first unit selected from the population, then this sample is recorded, measured and written again in the population before the next sample is drawn. Continue this procedure until the required number of sample size is drawn. Suppose for example, this is the population containing the 100 individuals, that is population size is 100. We need to draw, that is we need the samples 10. So how to collect the samples by using the simple random sampling with replacement? The sampling units are chosen with replacement in the sense that the chosen units are placed back again in the population. So, what is the method of simple random sampling with replacement? Select the first sample from the population. So, select any sample, because in simple random sampling, each and every unit in the population has the equal chance of selection. So, select randomly any one sample. Then measured and recorded this sample. Suppose I am interested in calculating the height of students. There are the 100 students and we need the height of 10 students. So first sample is selected from the population. Then measure the height of these students. Suppose the height of student is 5 feet. Okay. So measure and recorded the height of the student, and this student again placed back in the population before the next draw. That means here again the samples population size is 100, because this sample again placed back in the population. Again then select randomly any unit from the population, measured and recorded this sample, and this sample again put back in the population before the next draw. This procedure is continued until the sample size n is drawn. That means measure the height of 10 students here, and this procedure is stopped after the 10th observations we are given. Okay. So this is the simple random sampling with replacement. So in simple random sampling with replacement, there is the chance of repeated object to be, that means there is the chance of selection of same sample again and again. Okay. Now the next is simple random sampling without replacement. In this type of sampling, first unit selected from the population, then this sample is recorded, measured and do not written again in the population before the next sample is drawn. Continue this procedure until the required number of sample size n is drawn. The sampling units are chosen without replacement in the sense that the unit once are chosen are not placed back in the population. Same example, suppose there are the 100 students in the population, that is the population size is 100. We need 10 students, that we need the height of 10 students. I am interested in calculating the height of students. So we need the sample of 10. So first randomly select one student and measure and recorded height of that student. Suppose the height of that student is 6. Then what is the simple random sampling without replacement? Select the sample from the population, measure and recorded this sample, but this sample are not placed back again in the population. That means in the next step, what is the population size? It decreased by the 1 unit. So here the population size is 99. Then next, again select randomly the second student, measure and recorded the height of the student. Suppose the height is 5.5 feet. Then this sample are not placed again back in the population. Then in next step, the population size is decreased by the 1 unit, so 98. This procedure is continued until the sample size n is drawn. Here the n is 10. So this procedure is continued up to 10 times, that is 10 times. Okay, so this is the simple random sampling without replacement. In simple random sampling without replacement, population size is decreased by the 1 unit in every step. Now the next is restricted random sampling. There are 3 types of restricted random sampling. First is stratified random sampling, second is systematic random sampling, and third is cluster sampling. So first is stratified random sampling. This stratified random sampling is used when the population is heterogeneous. In this case, heterogeneous population is divided into the homogeneous groups or subgroups. These subgroups is called as the strata. And from each stratum, sample is drawn. See, the stratified random sampling is used when the population is heterogeneous. First, divide this heterogeneous population into homogeneous groups. These homogeneous groups is called as the strata, and the select the sample from each strata. A stratified sampling may be either proportionate or disproportionate. In the proportionate stratified sampling, the number of sample is drawn from each strata is proportional to the size of strata. That is, they take the equal number of samples from each stratum. In disproportional stratified sampling, the number of samples drawn from the each strata is not proportional to the size of strata. That means there is no need to take the equal number of samples from each stratum. That is, unequal sample size is selected from the each stratum. Proportional stratified sampling is frequently regarded as the most efficient system of the sampling against the disproportional stratified sampling. Let's see one example. So this is the heterogeneous population. Suppose the example of students in Agriculture College of Baramati. There are the different streams of the Agriculture College of Baramati. There is the College of AS, that is Animal Husbandry, Agri, Agribusiness Management, Polytechnic and Mani course. So the students, all the students in Agriculture College and Allied Sciences is gathered in the classroom or in auditorium. Okay, so this population is nothing but the heterogeneous. So the stratified sampling is used when the population is heterogeneous. So what is the next step of stratified random sampling? First, divide this heterogeneous population into homogeneous groups. So AH, then Agri, ABM, that is BBA, Polytechnic and MADI. There are the 5 homogeneous groups. These homogeneous groups is called as the strata. How to make the strata? Within strata, they are more homogeneous, but between strata, they are heterogeneous. Okay. So, what is the next step? Select the sample from each stratum. The condition of stratified random sampling is that select the sample from each stratum. If the sample size is selected, suppose the population is 5,000 students and I need suppose 10 students. That is, population size is 5,000 and sample size is 10. So, suppose I am selecting 3 students from the Animal Husbandry College, two students from the Agri College, 1 student from the Agribusiness Management, 2 students from the Polytechnic College, and 2 students from the MADI College. Okay. So, here I am selecting the 10 students from each stratum, but I am selecting the 3 students from the AH, 2 students from Agri, 1 student from Agribusiness Management, 2 students from Polytechnic Diploma, and 2 students from MAI. That means here is the unequal sample size. That means unequal samples are selected from each stratum, so called as the disproportional stratified sampling. And suppose if we are chosen the equal sample from each stratum, then it is called as the proportional stratified sampling. So this is the stratified sampling. Stratified sampling is used when the population is heterogeneous. First, divide this heterogeneous population into homogeneous groups. These homogeneous groups is called as the strata. How to make the strata? Within strata, they are more homogeneous, but between they are heterogeneous. Select the sample from each stratum. If the sample is selected from each stratum is equal, then it is called as the proportional stratified sampling. And if the sample is selected unequal from each stratum is called as the disproportionate stratified sampling. Now the next is systematic sampling. This method is popularly used in those cases where the complete list of population from which the sample is drawn is available. Note that complete list is available. In this method, sample is to select every kth item from the list, where k is the sampling interval. How to calculate k? Size of population, that is population size, capital N divided by sample size, that is small n. The first sample is randomly selected any between the 1 to k. Then after every kth item, sample is selected from the series. See, for example, suppose we have 100 students, 1 to up to 100. We have the complete list of students. Here the capital N is 100, and suppose we need the 20 students, N is equal to 20. So the first step of systematic sampling is to calculate the K, that is sampling interval. How to calculate K? Capital N divided by small n. So 100 divided by 20, that is 5. Now the first select any sample between 1 to 5. So select any unit from the series 1 to 5. So here I am selecting the number 4, that is 4th student. Now after that, select every kth, that is 4th item. So first select 4th student, then after every kth, here k value is 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then select 9 number students. After every 5th, because here k value 5, so 5th observation is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th. So next selected student number is 14. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is 19. This procedure is continued until the sample size 20 is drawn. So here the selected students serial numbers are 4, 9, 14, 19, 24, 29, 34, 39, 44, 49, 54, 59, 64, 69, then 74, then 79, 84, 89, 93, and last is 99. So this is the systematic random sampling. Now the last is multi-stage or cluster sampling. As the name implies, this method refers to a procedure which is carried out in several stages. The population is regarded as made up of the number of first stage units, sampling units, each of is made of number of second stage unit, etc. At the first stage unit are sampled by the some suitable methods such as simple random sampling. Then a sample is second stage unit is selected from each of the selected first units, stage units, again by some suitable method which may be the same as or the different from the method employed for the first stage unit. This method is useful in case of heterogeneous population. In this case, heterogeneous population is divided into the different homogeneous subgroups. The subgroups is known as example. So this is suppose the heterogeneous population containing the 50,000 farmers from the different district. That means the population is heterogeneous. We need the 5,000 farmers for the study. Our sample size is 5,000. So cluster sampling is used when your population is heterogeneous. So first divide this heterogeneous population into homogeneous groups. Groups is made up by using the district. Okay. So these homogeneous groups is called as clusters. In stratified sampling, these homogeneous groups is called as strata, but in cluster sampling, these homogeneous groups is called as the clusters. Then select some cluster among all cluster at a random. That means select the sample using the simple random sampling. That means at a random. Okay. Then this is the first stage. Now in second stage, select the sample by using the random sample from that selected cluster. That means select the some samples, that means 5000 samples from that selected cluster. So this is called as the cluster sampling. So see again, the cluster sampling is used when the population is heterogeneous. First divide this heterogeneous population into homogeneous groups. These homogeneous groups is called as the clusters. Then select some cluster among all cluster at a random. That means by using the simple random sampling. Then select the sample from that selected cluster called as the cluster sampling. Okay. So, what is the difference between the systematic and cluster sampling? In a systematic sampling, we need to select the sample from each stratum. But in cluster sampling, we have choice of select the same cluster among all the clusters. Okay, so this is the basic difference between the cluster sampling and stratified random sampling. So, this is the topic sampling. Thank you.